I often wonder how folk who don't venture into the mountains stay sane. The mountains help me to think clearly, sift through problems and put other troubles into perspective. The exquisite feeling of linking moves high above gear on beautiful rock, or simply moving over the mountainside high above the valley floor, focuses the mind and empties it of clutter. It's a much sought after, seldom found sense of the perfect moment. A childhood perched on the edge of the wild Atlantic in Cornwall, embedded a need within me for wide open spaces and endless skies. My wonderful grandma would take me scrambling across the rocks by the sea, sharing her sense of adventure and teaching me how to notice, how to stay calm, how to be myself. Moving away felt like a terrible wrench, but my school rucksack club brought escape to the mountains, and walking up hills felt like second nature. For a long time, I'd have said the most testing part of my climbing life has been my journey to become a mountain guide, or a particular climb that was dangerous and hard. But now, having just turned 50, perhaps it's the acceptance that I won't do all the things I thought I would, that staying fit and injury-free is a daily battle, and worst of all, that I'll soon be outclimbed by my daughters.
I didn't walk how you said I should walk. I walk how I do walk, and that's fine. It didn't go how you said it would go. It went how it did go, and that's fine.
That they love being out and about in wild places is a joy. That they both love climbing is a miracle. How many 12 and 16 year olds would choose climbing trips as their number one holiday? But I'm cautious though. I treasure each trip as the last, ready for a time when they might drift off in other directions. I want them to discover who they are, what makes them feel truly alive, and be true to that. Anything else will feel inferior, pointless even.
I heard you say, meet you in the long grass. Something good at long last. When we're away.
Zoe and Ruby helped me to grow roots here in North Wales. Snatching mini-adventures in preciously short time slots. North Wales is perfect for that. Small scale, but big character. Climbing here can be a busy, buzzy affair. The sheer number of keen and psyched folk who pitch up in North Wales keep it vibrant. And yet, as a long-time resident, you know how to find the empty quarters, have crags to yourself, a sense of peace and space. Know whether to head into the mountains or escape the rain at the coast. I didn't set out to be committed to climbing, no one does. But looking back on the last 30 years, I realise it's turned out that way. I feel incredibly lucky to have found my thing, the part of me that has given my journey through life the most meaning, the most shape. It's a commitment equalled only by the one I feel to my girls. That they too now believe their climbers is an honour. There are these amazing little moments like a flow of understanding between us. They understand my passion, who I really am, and though their climbing journey is just beginning, I can empathise with their triumphs and frustrations. It feels very real and very precious. Climbing has given me an excuse to live a life slightly less ordinary and has allowed me a freedom that so many people don't have access to. It has taken me to some very special environments in all weathers and given me a reason to be immersed in wild landscapes from sunrise to sunset. To feel tired, hungry, scared and exhausted, but ultimately to feel properly, truly 100% alive.